In 2017, ServiceNow introduced the Now Experience UI framework to power the agent workspace. Before this, UI features were mostly powered by commercially available technologies like Bootstrap and AngularJS, which tied future developments to updates and patches of that tech stack. The Now Experience UI framework breaks free of these restrictions and is a JavaScript framework based on the Web Component Standard. It is designed to integrate but not be binded to third-party libraries like SnapDOM and Redux. This framework allows for both internal and external component creation and is primarily used within UI Builder. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to set up your environment to get ready to build custom components using the Now Experience framework. I'll assume you have zero experience in building UI components, and this is a day one setup to get you started on your journey. First, we'll have to install Node.js on your operating system. Simply put, Node.js allows you to run JavaScript outside of a browser. Head on over to nodejs.org and click on the Downloads tab. The recommended version of Node.js is 12.16.1, so search for it and download the relevant installation file for your OS. It is good to note that Node Package Manager, or NPM for short, is also required, but that is installed together with Node.js. Think of NPM like an application store where you can download different packages to your development environment. The version that installs with our Node.js version is 6.13.4. Now that's done, head over to the ServiceNow store and download the ServiceNow CLI application. The file comes with different install files for different OSs, so once again, use the file that fits your OS. For Windows, ensure that CLI installs to C program files, and for Mac and Linux, ensure that Add to Path option is selected during installation. If you don't have a source code editor installed, now is the time to get one. I'll use Visual Studio Code as my IDE of choice, and is highly recommended if you're new to programming. You can get this for free on the official website, but feel free to stick to your preferred IDE if you already have one. We're now done with all the files you need to download and install.
But wait, there's more!
In total, there are 7 steps, and I'll walk you through each step. First, open up Visual Studio and click on Open Folder, then create or select an empty folder for the project. Next, open up a new terminal. We'll check that we have the right versions of Node.js and npm installed. So type npm-v to confirm that version 6.13.4 is installed, then node-v to confirm that version 12.16.1 is installed. If these versions are different, I highly encourage you to follow the earlier installation guide section to reinstall Node.js, as later, the results might vary. Next, type snc extension list-available, and if the ServiceNow CLI was installed correctly, you should see that the UI component is returned. However, we see that it's currently not installed, so we'll go ahead and install this by typing snc extension add --name UI-component. We are at step 3 now, where we need to configure the profile set. This will allow us to connect to the target ServiceNow instance. So go ahead and type snc configure profile set. Fill in your ServiceNow instance URL, choose login method as basic, enter the user account with an assigned admin role, enter the password, and choose the default output format as JSON. You should get a success message and you can ignore the dynamic commands message. This is now your default profile. At this point, log into your ServiceNow instance to retrieve the company code of the instance. To do this, go to System Properties by typing sys_properties.list in the filter navigator and press Enter. Then search for a property named glide.appcreator.company.code and copy the value. Mine is snc. Head back into Visual Studio and in the terminal, type snc ui-component project --name at the code you just copied, / a sample name, --, description, and enter your description. This will be the application scope the component will be stored in. Once completed, you should see in the Explorer some new files created, and we'll get to these soon. We are at step 5 now. Type npm install in the terminal to install all the required packages for component development. You'll see more files being added under the project. That's all for the setup. We are ready to develop our component now. This video doesn't cover any detailed component development, and I'll only be creating a Hello World component to be displayed in the UI Builder workspace. So go to the index.js file and enter your HTML code in between the div sections. I'm putting some simple styling via the styles.scss file and using that in the hello world message. By typing snc ui-component develop in the terminal, you can render the component in your web browser. Look for the URL after project is running at to see your component in action. Back to Visual Studio, terminate the local development instance by pressing Ctrl+C. Now locate and open the now-ui.json file and rename the label field to the name of the component you want to show up within your ServiceNow instance. You can change the icon and description as well if preferred, and then save all your files. Now for the last step, let's deploy the component. Ensure that your local development server is not running, and then in the terminal window, type snc ui-component deploy --open --force. Just as an FYI, the force command at the end of this line will overwrite any existing duplicate components, so you can continually use this command to overwrite a currently deployed component. After some loading, you should see a success message and you are done. To wrap this up, let's test our work. Head on over to your ServiceNow instance and open any UI Builder workspace. Here, I'll create a brand new empty one so it doesn't affect other workspaces. You can follow along the on-screen video to do the same. Once created, go to your workspace, click on any empty Add Component sections, and search for the component you just created. The component you built should now appear within the workspace. Congrats! You now have the ability to build any component using the Now Experience UI framework.
Okay. Celebrate.
Right.
Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.